I know just as sure as I stand here, and as my heart is beating like a muffled drum playing the funeral march to the grave, that whether I go to the grave or not, one day I'm going to hear the voice of the Lord. But for 2,000 years, we haven't heard a thing. I get a little leery and weary of this crowd that's always commanding the devil and raising the dead. Man, I've never seen such a bunch of just liars. You can tell the devil's crowd, they got some traits. Like him, they'll lie. And like him, they'll kill you. Psalm 37 said, the wicked watcheth thee and seek to slay thee. But for 1,000 years, the silence has been long, it's been prolonged, it's been absolute. And because of this silence, it's caused the scoffers to mock. This is how you've been preaching, it's been preaching, it's been hearing it all of your life. Where's the promise of His coming? You preacher, you Baptist, especially, you're a little erratic, you know, and you're out there on the outer rim of things anyway, and some of you are not sure if you got an elevator at all. And they mock. And the scoffers come. And they ridicule. And it's in the newspaper. You don't find a premillennial newspaper. And not only that, but the silence caused the saints to stumble. And we got some throwed in the towel and quit God. And some just laid down. And some stacked arms and said, you're not going to fight anymore. Than others, you just gathered back somewhere and built you a little place in an AWOL kind of condition. And no longer are you out there on patrol and you're not marching. And you hadn't built any foxholes. And you hadn't got out of the little place you're in to go out for a skirmish. And the devil's got you cowered down and laid down, and you forgot that you belong to the greatest army that ever was. After Calvary, you expect a silence. What more can he say than he said? What more can he do than he's done? There's been a silence. Not only that, but there's some sounds. It began with a shout. Said he's going to come with a shout. Now, boy, that's going to be something. I love to hear that. I aim to hear that. I'm going to hear that. I know that he's not man that he should lie. And what he's promised, he'll do it. He'll do it. And one of these mornings, hallelujah, it's going to be there. And I've never heard his voice, but I know his voice. And it's going to cry, come up Heather. Amen. Now, you're talking about being undignified and unorthodox and amen, boy, it's going to be time for it because 3 times the Lord shouted. He shouted at old Lazarus' tomb, and when he did, a dead man come out. He shouted on the cross, and it's finished, and he came out. And Old Testament saints came out. And he's going to shout again. And we're going out. Hallelujah. Going out. Not only the sound, there's a shout, but voice of the archangels. I don't know too much about it, but I do know this. When he came down below the angels. And I didn't get to finish what Jesus did when he was raised from the dead, and how that he went back to them sons of God that came down the days of Noah, and they lived like men, and when sons of God come down and live like men, they had to die like men, and Jesus had to die like a man. But them angels that came in and cohabited with the women, all the devils ever produced something twisted and distorted. God got them locked up down there in hell, and they lost their bodies celestial and lost their bodies terrestrial, and they tried to reproduce and come up with scum and junk and perverts and twisted. But when Jesus came and died, he died for a woman, and he shed his blood for the woman, and he saved. And that day he went down there and preached to those spirits, and it was a herald. It's like he's saying, "Goody, goody, goody." You didn't do it, but I did. You twisted it, and you lost your body. Look at you. No resurrection for you. But me, here's the resurrection. The Spirit of God caught him up. And the Bible said he spoiled principality. He put his foot on them and pulled the hide off of him. And made an open display of it. And that's the reason he came and shouted, "All hail!" Well, I know one day the amnesty's over. War's going to be declared. Ambassador's taken home. Going to be the trump of God. Not the trumpet, but the trump. The sound. Colored folks, I heard him in the thunder. And the trumpet sound within my soul. And I ain't got long to stay here. Not only silence and sounds, but sights. Two sights. First, those that died in Christ are going to get up. Oh, grave, where's thy victory? Wouldn't it be wonderful to look out there and see some of them old saints of God that used to be here? Some of them not here anymore. I can remember some of the old ones. And they've been put under the sod, but wouldn't it be wonderful to look out there and hear them walking, and they're going out there and they're listening how we sing and praise God and how we preach. And not only the dead, but we which are alive and remain. Going to be some sounds, going to be some sights, going to be some songs, going to be some comforts. We're to time we go out and bury saints of God, we ought to comfort one another with these words. A fellow named Charles Camel John. Now, I don't know if he's any kin to Camel Act or not. He was scientist and former chief engineer of the Apollo Project. And he's lecturing on how light travels 186.272 miles per second. That's fast. Your old Ford would outrun its lights. It'd get one feeble, well, what can I say, ooker of it. But he said you could go 3/4 the speed of light in space, and And you're gone out there 1 month, but back on earth on the calendar it'd be 2 months. And he said you could accelerate that thing more and get 99.9% of the age of the speed, rather, of light. And when you're gone 30 years or 30 days out yonder, 30 days back on earth, you're 10 years. 30 days, 10 years. And he said, you could accelerate that thing more to the speed of 99.999999. A lot of nines. That's almost 100%. And you could go into outer space, into our galaxy, and head towards the center of that thing, and you could be gone 27 years at that speed, and on Earth, it'd be 27,000. That's where you get 1,000 years as a day. And we know since Jesus been gone, it's been 2 days. Right? 2 days. Let me read you something here. In Genesis 41, Pharaoh had a dream. He had it twice. And here's what it said. And for that the dream was doubled unto Pharaoh twice, it is because the thing is established by God. And God will shortly bring it to pass. Now when you get 100%, oh, my soul. Material things do not exist. I mean, that's eternal life. And do you know the difference between 1,000 years is a day twice and that 100%? It's a moment and a twinkling of an eye. Amen. And we're there. Amen. That's enough.